In my opinion, pattern making is the king in shoemaking. Everything starts from pattern making. Even to make soles, insoles and heels, you still need to have pattern of all these details. So in this tutorial, I will show you all tools that you need to have to make your patterns, how to work with them, and specifically, I will talk about one tool that you need to have to create upper pattern, lining pattern, and half entire pattern of your shoes. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. Let's talk about tools that you will need to use in entire shoe pattern making. First thing that you need to have is cutting mat, this green cutting mat. To protect your table from scratching, you need to have it. If you can't find this type of the cutting mat, you can use your simple cutting board that you use for vegetables. Next tool that you need to have is two types of rulers, the simple straight ruler and the ruler with 90 degrees angle. Measurement tape. This one is special tape for shoemaking, but if you can't find this tape, you can use ordinary tape that we use in sewing clothes. Masking tape. I use masking tape with a width of 5 centimeters. And if you want to know more about this type of the tape, masking tape, you can check my full post, and link to this post is in the description below the video. Utility knife, simple utility knife. What is important here is to have good blade. I use this type of blade, BD100. It's excellent sharp blade, and to keep your blade always sharpened, you can check another video tutorial where I explain how to sharpen it, and a link to this tutorial you can find in the description. Simple pen, pencil, compasses, and these tools, and later I will talk more specifically about these tools, why we need it in pattern making. Hammer, I work with magnetic hammer and with nails, small nails that we use in lasting process. The small nails we use to attach back part of our upper to the insole. If you don't have this magnetic hammer, you can work without it. What you can do is use here small magnet and use it during pattern making. Cardboard must be flexible and not too thick and not too thin. We need also simple paper A4 to check our patterns from paper. Now, I think all these tools, it's very clear why we need to use them. Cardboard, we need to make our patterns. This tape, we need to measure certain lines on our last when we apply design of any footwear type. Pencil, we need to draw lines on the masking tape cover or on cardboard during pattern making process. Then the knife, we need to cut all our cardboards and paper pattern. Then rulers, we need also to make straight lines in pattern making. And for example, ruler with 90 degrees angle, we need in pattern construction of flat-bellied shoes or pumps or boots to measure, for example, heel height. Nails, we need when we attach our paper pattern on the last to check our paper pattern, and then to spread well this paper pattern to transfer our checked paper pattern to the cardboard. Compasses or these gauges that I have. I work in my constructions, in my shoe pattern constructions, I work with these gauges, but it's very difficult to find these gauges. So instead of these gauges that have specific distance between each between these two pins of each gauge, we can use compasses because it works in the same way. So we can open it on certain distance, close it on certain distance exactly as these gauges allow me to create different seam allowance in pattern construction. So these tools we need to have to add certain seam allowance to our pattern, any footwear pattern, where after we have basic pattern, we will need to develop upper and lining, and that's why we need to add seam allowance so we can work with compasses or with these tools. But I will not talk about these tools because it's very difficult to find these tools. Compasses is excellent replacement if you don't have these tools. Also, there is special compasses for pattern making where it has two sharp edges, okay? But this one is also good in shoe pattern making. Now, let's talk more about it. So, for example, you want to create all parts for your flat body shoes. And this one is basic pattern. You see, it doesn't have any seam allowance. So working with compasses, we will add seam allowance where we need to have it. Basic pattern doesn't have any seam allowance. It has only all, it contains only all lines that your shoe design has. And working with this basic pattern, by adding certain seam allowance, we develop upper pattern and lining pattern. So let's talk about most common seam allowance that you as a beginner in shoemaking can use during your work, during your shoemaking learning. First seam allowance is seam allowance for the folding. So if you want to create in your flat body shoes folding in top line, you will need to add here to this top line 4 millimeters. So for folding, we add 4 millimeters. How does it work? You will use cardboard. Then you will need to place your basic pattern that must be correct, that must be checked from ordinary paper. Also, you need to make first prototype, for example. And this is how you will check your paper, your pattern. And then you can work with this basic pattern and create different designs of flat body shoes or pump shoes or any other footwear type. So folding, you need to add for folding 4 millimeters. So that's why you will need to open the compasses in this distance of 4 millimeters. And add parallel line to the top line or any other line to which you want to add 4 millimeters. And you will have this 4 millimeters that you need to have when you want to fold any edge of your footwear, any edge on some of the parts of your footwear. Okay, so 4 millimeters for seam allowance. Next important seam allowance that you will use during pattern making, pattern construction is, and I will talk an example of this, basic pattern of the sneakers. So next important seam allowance is underline. To sew two parts together, if you have few parts inside of your upper, you will need to add this seam allowance. So this seam allowance is 8 millimeters, and we need to add 8 millimeters to the line on our shoe pattern to which we will want to assemble another detail. For example, you see here, this is the middle part of the sneakers, the one of the parts of the sneaker quarters. And here we have this element that will be attached on top of this middle part. So to attach this part, you see this one, we will need to have here underline. So that's why we need to add to this line to which we want to attach another detail, 8 millimeters. So you will do it in the same way. You will transfer this line. Here we have. I don't have here cuts, let's say here. For example, I want to add 8 millimeters for this detail. So I will need to transfer entire shoe detail for my basic pattern, let's say this one, and to the line, to one of the lines to which I want to add underline the seam allowance of 8 millimeters, I will use compasses. I will need to open compasses on the distance of 8 millimeters, and then I will add to this line 8 millimeters. Okay, and then to transfer this line to the leather, we will need to make here cuts. So we will be able to transfer this line to leather. In order to know until which line we need to attach detail that will be connected with this part of the upper or lining that has underline. Okay, so if I will not have this mark, I will not know exactly how I need to place this part of my upper that must be attached on top of another part of the upper or lining. Okay, that's why we need to have marks of underline. And last important seam allowance, there are a few, but these three seam allowances is most common seam allowances that you will use in your pattern construction as a beginner in shoemaking. So the next one is seam allowance that we usually add in the back part of boots, of ankle boots, or for example in lining pattern construction of pumps, flat ballet shoes. We will need to add to the back part of lining of flat ballet shoes 2 millimeters for the seam allowance to sew here this part. You will need to open your compasses on the distance of 2 millimeters, and if it will be sometimes difficult working with compasses in this pattern construction, for example, I created here 2 millimeters. But if you have difficulty with this 2 millimeters working with your compasses, you can work differently. You can use your basic pattern as a guideline to add 2 millimeters to the part of your upper on lining to which you want to add 2 millimeters. For example, let's imagine that here I need to add 2 millimeters to this back part of the lining, and my compass doesn't work good. So I will use basic pattern as a guideline to create this line. I need to mark 2 points in the distance of 2 millimeters from the back line, and then working with this line of the basic pattern back line of the back of the basic pattern, I can create here this seam allowance to my lining pattern or any other pattern that where we have this seam allowance. But usually we have the seam allowance in the back part of our shoes, in most of the cases, it is in the lining, in the back part of lining of flat-bottom shoes, pump shoes, or any other court shoe, court footwear type. Okay, so these were three main seam allowances that you need to use in your pattern construction, and you can do it working with simple compasses that you can buy in your local store. And entire tools of for shoe pattern making, you saw they are very basic tools, simple tools that you can find in your local store. Work with them and create patterns for your shoes. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching and see you in my next video. Don't forget to click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you and see you. Bye.